Appendix C of the user manual has tables that list every parameter for each I/O in one simple, concise location. These are great to use as checklists to make sure you don't forget anything when you're setting the parameters. While we did all of the analog input videos using keypad entry, remember that all of that could have been done using the free GSoft 2 software that you can download from AutomationDirect.com. There's a whole separate set of videos that show you step-by-step exactly how to use that GSoft 2 application to configure and operate the drive. Because analog input 3 can handle plus and minus 10 volts, it does gain a little differently than analog inputs 1 and 2. Gain and offset for inputs 1 and 2 are just the equation for a line. The gain is the slope, and the offset is the y-intercept. The difference is, analog input 3 has a gain parameter for the positive side and another parameter for the negative side. That's handy for when you have a process that normally runs in one direction, but you want to limit the max possible speed in the other direction using the negative voltage as an input. A good example of this is a reverse jog, where you use the negative voltage for the reverse direction. Analog inputs can easily be affected by noise. The best practices are: use shielded wire, connect the shield to the ACM terminal, especially if the noise is from an inductive source. Grounding the shield at the drive end is all you need. Don't ground the other end of the shield because you can create a current loop that'll just create more noise. Keep the wire away from long parallel runs with power lines or other noise-inducing wires. Now, if the noise is coming from the AC motor drive, consider adding a capacitor and a ferrite core like this. Make sure the wire is wound around that core at least 3 times, more if possible. And check this out. Do a search at AutomationDirect.com for EMI RFI techniques. It's a white paper that discusses the different types of EMI, sources of EMI, what types of devices suffer from EMI, how to measure EMI, and an excellent checklist of all the things you can do to help mitigate EMI and RFI issues in your system. The terminal board switches that switch analog inputs 1 and 2 between current and voltage are backwards from each other. Analog input 1 has a voltage in the up direction, and analog input 2 has it in the down position. So don't assume they both work in the same direction. Analog inputs can be used for PID set point, feedback, or offset. That's a big topic by itself, so it's covered in a separate video. This is a cool feature. If you remove these two screws, the terminal board can be pulled out to make wiring easier. When done, just push it back in until the connector mates and reinsert the two screws. Well, that ought to be enough to get you going. Click here to learn more about the GS4 drive. Click here to learn more about Automation Direct's free support options, and click here to subscribe so you'll be notified when we publish new videos.